Namaste everyone and welcome back to my channel. Sorry I haven't posted videos in quite some time, but now we will continue with the videos on hypospadias and we will start with the principles of the surgical repair. Now, as far as timing is concerned, it is a general consensus that the surgery should be performed between 6 to 18 months of age. A lot of centers believe the earlier the better, especially if it is meant to be a two-stage repair. Now, the idea is that the total surgical procedure should be completed before the child is ready to go to school, which will help relieve with social anxiety, and this is therefore considered a good timing for the repair. Now, the principles or the ideas that you should have in mind is as to what we are going to achieve with the surgical procedures is that you have to remember four plasties. So we have orthoplasty, which means straightening of the phallus, meatoplasty, that is the position of the opening of the urethra, urethroplasty, reconstructing a urethra which has adequate length and caliber, and ultimately glansplasty, so that you have a proper shape of the glands as well. Some also include scrotoplasty, which includes a proper skin cover and a proper reconstruction of the scrotal area as well. Now, for the principles, you have to also remember that less is more. Minimal trauma should be given to the tissues. They are very delicate. It is performed at a younger age. You have to do a layered repair. So you have to separate the skin from the urethra lining. And for this, waterproofing must be done. Now, this means that an intervening layer should be present, which will help to separate the skin and the urethra and helps to form a leak-proof closure. That is where the sutures will also be important. That's why it is considered that the sutures which are used have to be absorbable and they have to be minimally traumatic and they should not evoke greater reactions. We will see in the following video what kind of sutures are supposed to be used. Now, the goals of your repair are that you want the child to be able to micturate in the standing position. There should be a near normal appearance of the phallus and the glands along with the slit shaped meatus. And for the future sexual functions, it is important that the cordy should be relieved completely so that during sexual intercourse, there is no bending of the phallus. Now, the procedures that are available are depending on whether they are single versus a two-stage repair. Now, if the hypospadias, as we had seen in the classification, is a distal one, we can manage with a single repair wherein the cordy correction as well as the urethroplasty are both done in a single stage because you have sufficient tissues and the deficiency is less. So it's depending on the demand and the supply. The popular techniques for this single stage repair are the MAGPIE, which is meatoplasty, and glansplasty procedures incorporated, originally described by Duckett. We have TIP, which is tubularized incised plate by Snodgrass, flip-flap procedure by Matthew, and ASOPA, one of the Indian techniques. Now, in the following videos, I will describe these techniques one by one to the best of my knowledge. The two-stage repair is used for proximal cases of hypospadias, where the urethral opening is much more proximal, so the deficiency of the urethra is much more, the tissue availability is very less, and that's why in this case you have to repair the cordy in the first stage, and then only in the second stage we can go for a urethroplasty. The popular known ones are, then they are done 6 months apart, and for example it is the BRCA's two-stage repair, the Byers two-stage repair, and for extreme cases and like we have hypospadias cripples, we have the Cecil Culp technique. Now, ASOPA, the Indian technique, can usually be applied to both these situations depending on how the tissue reconstruction is done. So in the next video, we will see what are the perioperative considerations that have to be kept in mind while operating for hypospadias.